Well, thank the Lord, I'm on Terracotta once again, but guys, I've got one arm in a sling and one foot in a tub of arnica, and a sort of yacht to no better feeling in my conscience, and Nancy just told me that I'm a bigger fool than Thompson's colt, and he swum a river to get a drink. Well, we've just had our 4th of July celebration, and it was a great affair. We had the Pumpkin Center Silver Cornet Brass Band, and I Atkins was Marshal of the Parade, riding on Lige Willett's spotted horse, what he got from the circus busted here. We had all the best-looking gals in Pumpkin Center dressed up to represent the different states and talk about real estate sharks, guys. Now, as fellas are just wishing for a whole state all for themselves. And we had the Grand Army Post consisting of Jim Lawson, Abe Crosby, and Ezra Hoskins. Jim was carrying a sword, Abe had a musket, and Ezra was carrying the banner. And then come the Pumpkin Center Glee Club, and so we marched down to the Grove. Guys, the parade was fully 20 corn shucks long. While we got down to the Grove, the Grand Army Post stood at parade rest, Abe Crosby sitting on a stump, Ezra Hoskins leaning against a tree, and Jim Lawson trying to get his wooden leg between the running gears and hub of a wagon so he could sit on it. Well, after the Glee Club had sung the old Union Wagon, Deacon Witherspoon stood up to read the Declaration of Independence, while the deacon said he had lost the book what had it in, but he could remember it, so he said, "Fellow citizens, when in the course of human events it becomes necessary for one people to sever the bonds which have so long held them in hot signal fences, or in the words of Napoleon at the Battle of Bunker Hill, hic jacet non compos mentis tempus fugit." Then comes the immortal George Washington, and as Julius Caesar at the siege of Vicksburg, "Sic semper tyrannis e pluribus unum." Just then the grandstand fell down and the stakes got all mixed up. Jim Lawson said it was plain to be seen that the North and South were united, cause Rhode Island was setting in the lap of Georgie. Just then everybody seemed to have an uncommon thirst for water, and some of them had drunk as much as 10 cups of it when we found that Jim Lawson had hung a jug of whiskey in the well and it had got busted. Just then the greasy pig got loose and upset all the tables, and Samantha Hoskins fell in a tub of lemonade, and the darn critter kept a running till it fell in the well, and Bullseye Pettingill in after it. Well, we got Cy out, and then Hank Weaver and Abe Crosby and me went to fire the national salute. We didn't have any cannons, so we used a couple of anvils. While we didn't have any powder, so we got some dynamite, what was over in the stone quarry, so we loaded up the anvils and tried to touch him off when Hank remembered you have to explode dynamite by discussion. So we stood off and throwed stones at it. Well, that's about all I can remember now. Hank Weaver will be buried Sunday if we can keep him till then, but the weather is pretty hot. They ain't found the anvils or Abe Crosby yet. And Nancy says, "Thank the Lord, next year we are going to have a safe and sanitary 4th of July."